oikein paljon kiitoksia. Kiitoksia. Oikein hyvää iltaa, Tapiola Sali. Hyvää iltaa, striimiyleisö, Beatles, diggarit Suomessa, muualla, ympäri maailmaa. Onpa suuri kunnia, hieno paikka olla täällä ja saada osallistua tähän Helsinki Beatles Weekendiin. Upeeta.
Also welcome our international audience at home or wherever you are behind your streams. Hope everything is technically working okay and you can hear us. We're gonna have a great night today. And the next one, Hate.
Yeah, yeah.
We're gonna start the next one.
Where she
kiitoksia.
Thank you so much. We're getting, gonna play some rock, so it's getting hot.
Pojille tuli kuuma, ei mulle.
The next one is one of my favorite Beatles tunes. We made our own rendition of No Reply. We gave it some speed, some TLC. You're gonna hear it now. This has the worst before.
Kiitoksia.
You're gonna lose that
yes,
girl.
Yes, yes, you're gonna lose that girl.
You're gonna lose.
Yes, yes, you're gonna lose that girl.
If you don't take her out tonight, she's gonna change her mind.
She's gonna change her mind.
And I will take her out tonight, and I will treat her. Paljon kiitoksia, paljon kiitoksia. Tämä äskeinen kappale on ehdottomasti yksi mun suosikkikappaleita. Mä tykkään sitä niin kovasti. Se on upeat temmat ja hieno, hieno vetää. Ja Eiks Karilla ole semmonen hieno kitara seuraavassa kappaleessa?
Hei, nyt meillä vaihtuu nimittäin soitin. Mitäs Jussi sanot tästä?
Siis 12-kielinen Rickenbackeri. Musta on aplodien paikka. Kari soittaa semmoista kitaraa. Eikö se aika legendaarista Beatles-musaa soitetaan oikealla kitaralla?
So we have upcoming the original 12-string Rickenbacker guitar, which is an essential part of 60s Beatles music. And playing it for it tonight for us here is Kari Aulo.
Pojat pääsi yllättämään. Pikku jäyn.
Yeah, the next song we're gonna feature, which will feature this guitar, is called Anytime at All. Anytime at all. Thank you so much.
Okei. Ja seuraavaksi vedetään sellainen Ringon tunnetuksi tekemä kappale, jonka hän lauloi ensimmäisenä biisinään Beatles-levylle, jonka nimi oli Beatles, LP:n nimi oli Please, Please Me, mutta tämän biisin nimi on Boys. One, two, three. Thrill, 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 thrill Se oli Ringoa.
Paljon kiitoksia.
Seuraavassa kappaleessa me tarvitaan teidän apua kiertosäkeessä. Siinä on hyvin yksinkertaiset sanat, jotka alkaa hei. Osaatteko? Hei. Hyvä. Ja se jatkuu sillä lailla, että Kari aloittaa tämän biisin soittamisen jossain vaiheessa. Ja sitten siihen heihin jatketaan vielä. You got to hide your love away. Menikö liian vaikeaksi? Ei munkaan mielestä.
Try, I can never win. Hearing them.
them in the state I'm in. How could she say to me, love will find a way? Gather round all you clowns, let me be safe. Hey, you got the high news of the way. Hey, you got the high news of the way. Nyt on teidän vuoro. Hey!
Sitten mennään 8 päivää viikossa. 8 days a week.
Thank you so much.
Paljon kiitoksia, paljon kiitoksia. Seuraava kappale tulee levyltä Hard Day's Night, ja sieltä me on aika paljon kappaleita tänä iltana esitetty. Siellä on hyviä biisejä, sopii meidän bändille. Ja seuraava kappale, Can't Buy Me Love, oli tosiaan, se on julkaistu 64, eli se oli varmaan suurimpaa hittiä siihen aikaan, kun bändi on perustettu, 65. Muistaaksä, Janne?
Joo, mä muistan sen. Mulla on jotenkin hatarat muistikuvat siitä edellisestä vuodesta, mutta mä muistan sen vuoden tosi hyvin.
65, se oli kova hitti. Joo. Silloin ja silloin perustettiin bändiä, eikö niin?
Kyllä, kyllä. Se innoitti kyllä meitä silloin aloittamaan.
Loistavaa, loistavaa. Ehkä me kuitenkin soitetaan se. Can't buy me love.
Kiitos. Thank you. Outside there, somewhere.
Seuraavaksi mennään semmoinen todella kaunis kappale, joka silloin kun isäni perustajajäsenenä oli tässä bändissä, tämä oli yksi hänen lempikappaleistaan, yksi kauneimpia balladeja Beatlesin ohjelmistosta, nimittäin sellainen kappale kuin If I Fell. Mennäänkö Jussin kanssa? Herkistellään vähän.
Lähdetään. Joo. Ei pois täältä, mutta herkistellään.
Niinpä. If I fell in love with you, would you promise to be true and help me understand? 'Cause I've been in love before and I found that love is more than just holding hands. If I If I fell, thank you.
You know you got me.
Kiitos. It's been a great night, and it's going to be an even greater night. We got a couple more songs to play for everybody here in Tapiola, there at home, wherever you are. A big thanks to Helsinki Beatles Week and for bringing us here.
Suuri kiitos, ollut suuri kunnia olla täällä. Ihan mahtavat tunnelmat ollut täällä soittaa. Meillä on pari biisiä vielä jäljellä, mitkä me soitetaan. Ja kiitoksia tosiaan Helsinki Beatles Week -organisaattoreille, että saitte aikaan näin upean tapahtuman. Kiitoksia tässä vaiheessa jo. Siitä, että saadaan olla mukana täällä näin.
Ja muistakaa ensi keväänä Beatles Weekend toukokuussa. Ostakaa lippuja sinne, eiks niin?
Ja iso kiitos vielä kaikille täällä Tapiola-salissa. Mahtavaa, että te tulet katsomaan. Kiitos.
Kiitos teille.
Mennään pari biisiä vielä. Aivan, ja seuraavassa kappaleessa me tarvitaan teidän apuja. Okei, treenataan tää seuraava kerran. Se alkaa näin. Missä se on? Anna mulle sointi, kiitos. She loves you. Ja te vastaatte jee, jee, jee. Kolme jeetä. Kokeillaan kerran vielä. Okei. She loves you. Ja vielä. She loves you. Yes. She loves you. Te osaatte tämän. Mennään yhdessä.
kiitoksia.
Thank you very much.
Tosi paljon kiitoksia. Hienoa iltaa.
Thank you, you've been a lovely audience. Thank you to everybody out there. Stand by for Jiri Nikkinen, Bill's band.
Hyvää iltaa, Helsinki, Finland. Kiitos, thank you very much. I'm Jay Gepner, greeting everyone from Chicago, Illinois, in the United States of America. All right, oh, I loved the 2019 Helsinki Beatles Weekend. That was great. It was in the theater where Jimi Hendrix played, and I remember walking in and just getting off the plane and Tappany picking me up, and we went to the theater, and I just remember the vibe and the feeling. It was such a great vibe coming out of there. And the band from Budapest, the Blackbirds, they were doing their sound check at the time, and great musicians they were, and just had so much fun at the Helsinki Beatles weekend. What was especially fun was meeting all the wonderful people, but getting a chance to play with all the bands. They were very nice, and most of them, all of them, invited me up to do a song with them, and it was a lot of fun. A lot of fun. I really love it.
She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you. She loves you, and you know you should be glad. She said you had a soul, she almost like her mind. Now she said she knows you're not the hurting kind. She said she loves you, and you know that can be bad. And she loves you. Should be glad.
want to say that hopefully all this craziness and the COVID stuff, hopefully we could get out there and start performing live again. And I just can't wait to be back in your beautiful country of Finland.
But then again, you're not to blame. You're just a human, a victim of the insane. We're afraid of everyone, afraid of the sun. Salvation. The sun will never disappear, but the world may not have many years.
Thank you. Kito. John Lennon has been the most significant Beatle to me. I mean, I loved them all. I still do. I love Paul McCartney and George Harrison, Ringo Starr, of course. But seeing my name was John, I automatically had this liking for John. And then when I seen A Hard Day's Night, I got to experience what kind of personality he was, and he was very quick-witted and funny, and I just thought he was great. And John is my guy. I love everything about Finland, and you know, you got a great country and a lot of beautiful people, and I miss y'all. I can't wait to get back there. Everybody get ready, because 2021 is going to be a better year. Let's see, I believe it's May 4th. The first weekend of May, I believe that's in Helsinki, is going to be the Beatles week.
Oh, hello folks, it's me. I'm so excited to tell you I'm going to be singing to you on the Helsinki Beatles weekend 2021. Yeah, see you there folks. Take care, much love, and bye for now.
I can only speak my mind to
terveisiä Tyrväältä, Sastamalasta, Laituri Kahvilasta. Ollaan tulossa Beatles-tapahtumaan ensi vuonna keväällä. Ja tämähän oli What Goes On. Jussi Syrjänä The Grand Breakers toivottaa kaikki tervetulleeksi keväällä kutsalle Beatles-tapahtumaan.
Peace and love, peace and love, Helsinki. And it'll just be wonderful to come see everybody again. And meet you in person. Thank you, too, for all you do. Seriously, you know, to have that kind of passion, you know, and to bring people together, you know, for peace and love and Beatles is just a beautiful thing. It doesn't get any better than that. You know, I've been to many, many Beatle festivals all over the world, and it's an atmosphere, and the energy is how you would love the rest of the world to be all the time. You know, I don't want to leave these festivals because of the positive and love-filled energy there. And it's kind of a drag to come back to the real world, you know, with all the insaneness.
Got to pay your dues if you wanna sing the blues. You know it don't come easy. You don't have to shout or leap about. You can even play them easy. Forget about the past and all your sorrows. The future won't last. much I only won't trust. You know it don't come easy, and this love of mine keeps growing all the time. You know it don't come easy. Open up your heart, let's come together. Use a little love and we will make it work out better, yeah. Got to pay your dues if you wanna sing no blues. You know it don't come easy. You don't have to shout or leap about. You can even play them easy. Remember peace is how we make it. Use a little love and we will make it work out better. I don't ask for much, I only won't trust. You know it don't come easy. This love of mine keeps growing all the time. You know it don't come easy. All right.
Thank you very much.
Someone who's doing what I'm doing. So that just blew my mind that I'm the only one, you know, I feel like a chosen one, you know, and that I'm, you know, to be able to not only be a Beatle tribute artist, but to be Ringo and then be the only one is, I guess it was my destiny, without a doubt.
Helsingissä.
Vi ses i Helsingfors.
And can't wait to see you all. Miss you all. Kiitos. Love you. Take care.
No niin. Oliko Tinos hyvä? Kyllä, aivan mahtava. Ja tosiaan nyt ruvetaan pikkuhiljaa jatkamaan meidän live-ohjelmaa. Ja meillä on tässä meidän hieno mallimme. Mietittiin, että kumpiko meistä on nätimmän näköinen, ja päätti, että Ville on nätimmän näköinen. Että
ihan helppo valinta.
Tässä mallaillaan vähän tämmöisiä hienoja maskeja on meillä kotisivuilla myynnissä, ja isolation-paitoja. Tosiaan tuossa äsken vähän puhuikin näistä isolation-paidoista, että näitä on vielä jonkin verran jäljellä. Kannattaa käydä siellä katsomassa meidän kotisivuilla, mitä siellä on jäljellä vielä. And also, thank you for watching, everybody at home. Apologies for the little technical difficulties we had in the beginning, but now we're back in business, and I hope you all enjoy the show. And if you there at home have enjoyed the show, you can buy an optional live stream support ticket to support us, support the show, support the artist, and especially share the love. And you can find that on our website. It costs 10 euros. You can check it out there. Buy it if you like to support us. And we appreciate every single ticket you buy. We are doing this out of pure love for the Beatles and for the band. So we just appreciate your support. Thank you very much for everybody doing that. Ja kotimaisille katsojille meillä on myös olemassa tekstiviesti mahdollisuus ostaa lippuja. Eli kun lähettää tekstiviesti Beatles 10 numeroon 16301, voi ostaa tekstiviestillä 10 euron hintaisen tämmöisen kannatuslipun. Joten kannattaa hyödyntää myös tätä mahdollisuutta.
Hyvä. Ja nyt koronasta riippuen katsotaan, mitä ensi keväänä tapahtuu. Toukokuussa Helsinki Beatles Weekend tulee taas, niin kuin nähtiin tuossa videolla äsken, että minkämoinen kattaus sinne on tulossa. Hienoja orkestereita, enemmän Beatlesia, enemmän rakkautta sinne kaikki.
Absolutely. And for you at home as well, we're going to have Helsinki Beatles Weekend on May 7th and 8th next year. So be ready for that. Let's hope we have all this corona hassle over by then, and we can have a good festival, enjoy the festival, and just have fun everybody together. Mutta pidemmittä puheitta. Eiköhän me oteta seuraava bändi sisään. Elikkä me kuultiin tässä Tinosilta äsken huikea show, ja nyt on sitten vuorossa ehkä vähän sitä myöhempää Beatles-tuotantoa, ja siitä tulee esittää meille Jiri Nikkinen, The Beatles Tribute Band!
Sorry, but today is difficult to sing anything because my throat is okay. Ill now. Don't worry, I don't have any COVID-19 virus, but still I got some flu in my throat. But still, anyway, I do my best. Ja mulla on joku kurkunpää tuolla toista viikkoa ja kävin testeessä, ei ole korona eikä mitään tällaista, mutta ikäväkseni ääni on mennyt aika totaalisesti. Pitäisi esittää varmaan Harrisonin Bangladesh-konsertti tässä, mutta ei ehditty treenaa. Mut näillä mennään. Ja tähän monitoriin voisi se laulun ottaa kyllä, niin olisi kivempi.
Night.
flat. I'm back in the USSR. You're the lucky you are, boy. Back in USSR.
Aina se iskee se kurkun pää joskus kipeäksi ja näin nyt kävi ja mä just katson, että viimeksi oli silloin, kun oli se Beatles Weekend, kun me vedettiin se White Album, niin silloin se oli kans kipeä, että mitä tää osuu aina tähän. Ja tiedän tämän vitsauksen, Ja onneksi mulla on kollegoita ja ystäviä, mitä voi vähän kysyä apoja. Mä soitin Pepelle tänä. Ja aina vähän vaidalla, että nyt on sitä ja tätä. Ja nyt oli mun vuoro sitten kysyä, tai ei se ikinä mulla soita, mä aina kysyn, soitan sille. Että mitä mä teen, että nyt on illalla semmoinen, tätä ei voi peruuttaa ja pakko mennä. Otat sitä kortisonia, no sitä on nyt hevosannos tuolla elimistössä. Ja jos sekään jeesaa, niin purista munista.
You come flat to pick up, cruising up slowly, he got Kiitos. Thank you.
Kiitoksia, kiitoksia.
Hare Krishna. Nyt olisi Hofner hetken aika. Joo, okei, Abbey Roadin hankalin biisi, mitä kirjoista on lukenut, niin tähän meni pari viikkoa tämän tekemiseen ja lopputulos oli tämmöinen mitä hienon biisi ja sopii sille levylle täydellisesti.
John was crazy, started by the musical science in the home. Late nights all alone with a test tube on. Maxwell Edison, major in the medicine, calls her on the phone. Can I take you out to the pictures, John? But as he's getting ready to go, a knock comes on the door. Maxwell's silver hammer came down upon his head. Bang, bang, Maxwell's silver hammer made sure
she was dead. Back in school again, that's the place to fool again. Teacher gets a night, racing to a white and unpleasant sea. She tells Max to stay when the glass has gone away, so he waits behind, writing 50 times, I must not be so, oh, oh, oh. When she turns her back on the boy, he creeps up from behind. Bang, bang, Maxwell's silver hammer came down upon his head. She dirty one, Maxwell stands alone, painting testimonial pictures, John. She tells Max to stay when the glass has gone away, so he waits behind.
Maxwell must go.
Writing 50 times, I must not be so, oh, oh, oh. She turns the back of the boy, creeps up from behind. Bang, bang, Maxwell's silver hammer came down upon his head. Bang, bang, Maxwell's silver hammer made sure she was dead.
Thank you. Okay, sitten Harrisonin pariin taas, koska nämä on vähän George laulaa matalammalta kuin muut. Ja jos on vähänkin semmoinen olo, että haluaa selviytyä, niin Georgein biisit on varmempi. Someone controlled you. Hare Krishna. Kiitos. No enemmän tai vähemmän kaikki merkitsee, tai kaiket laulu kertoo rakkaudesta. Ja tämä seuraava on oikein hymni sille asialle. Kiitos John Lennonin.
associations, you break it down. I'll never give you my number. I only send you my invitation. And in the middle of investigations, I break it down.
Kiitoksia.
Kiitos. Thank you.
Yes, tällä näyttäisi nyt, me ikinä tehdä settilistoja, mutta nyt oli pakko tehdä, että valitaan vaan ne biisit, mitkä ehkä mahdollisesti pystyy tänään laulaa. Ja tämä seuraava on ainakin, pitäisi olla helppo sen suhteen, melodia ei mene korkealle, koska Paul ja John teki tämän Ringolle. Mutta tässä on semmoinen miina tässä biisissä, että tässä on sanoja aika paljon. Ja sitten kun tässä on lihannut vaan ja istunut sohvalla maaliskuusta asti, eikä hirveästi miettinyt näitä, niin tässä nyt kun voisi kuvitella, että tänne näkee ihan kuka ihminen tahansa maapallolla, niin tästä voisi tulla sanomista ja tämä jää historian kirjoihin soloinen päivineen. Mutta tekisi mieleen sanoa, että soitetaan biisi pois ja tämähän jää tähän neljän seinän sisällä, mutta näin ei ikävä kyllä ole. Eli soitetaan hyvin.
Kyllä. Kiitos Samuel.
I like to be under the sea in a his garden in the shade. He let us in, knows where we've been, in his octopus, his garden in the shade. I like to be, my friends to see, in octopus.
bruises. Got them with me. I'd like to be under the sea. His octopus is gone. Octopus has gotten near a cave. We would sing and dance around because we know we can't be found. I like to be under the sea in his octopus's garden.
Kiva mennä himaan ja syödä siinä jotain ja ottaa ehkä yksi olut ja pistää läppäri päälle ja katsoa tää sit.
Yeah.
Näin me kumminkin tehdään.
Kaikki kyllä joo.
Mutta tähän jäi elämään.
Ja sit siellä alkaa salaisessa Facebook-keskusteluryhmässä helvetinmoinen polemiikki.
Hei katolle vois mennä käymään.
Mennään ihmeessä.
Joo, hyvä.
Niin, mitä meillä on aikaa enää?
Yli puoli tuntia.
Nobody ever really told me. Yes, he told me. Yes, he does. First time. dummy. Ooh, she dummy me. She dummy me good. I guess nobody ever really dummy me. Ooh, she dummy me. She dummy me good.
Kiitoksia, kiitoksia.
Katsottiin tuossa, mikä meillä päätyi tällä keikalle tämä myöhäisempi Beatles-osasto, niin tuossa Jarkko kysyi, että arvatkaa, mikä on niin kuin kaikista vanhin biisi täältä. Ja sit, täällähän on vaikka mitä, mutta tämä You Won't See Me on yksi niitä vanhimpia niin kuin tässä setissä. Mutta tuo äskenhän oli vielä paljon vanhempi, koska Paul teki sen 57 jo sen biisi, vaikka ne levytti vasta sitten Let It Be. Mutta nyt mennään vuoteen 66.
Thank you.
Onneksi hyvä biisi. Seuraavakin on. Nämä on kaikki. Siinä mielessä helppoa. Ei ole välibiisejä. Tähän nyt on uusi tarina. Tähän seuraava styge, kun nyt on Amerikassa mustia kohdellaan huonosti. Ainahan siellä on ollut, mutta nyt se on noussut tosi otsikoihin ja syystäkin. Ja se on väärin. Ja ihan, tai ei pelkät mustat, kaikki ihmiset on sama-arvoisia, väristä katsomatta tietenkin. Tuossa pitäisi olla epäselvyyksiä kellään. Ja Liverpoolin pojat tiesivät hyvin, koska se oli satama kaupunki ja siellä oli 1800-luvulla jo intialaisia, kiinalaisia, mustia, paikallisia, kaikki sulassa sovussa siellä kattilassa. Ja nämä kun meni Jenkkeihin, ne jätkät 64, niin ne törmäsi siihen, että heidän omassa konsertissaan mustat istuu tällä puolella salia ja valkoiset tuolla. Ja jätkät ei suostunut soittamaan keikkaa, ellei yleisö saa mennä minne haluaa. Ja järkkäröitten oli sitten pakko suostua yhtyeen toiveeseen. Ja nyt tää on hyvä, että tää on niinku kehissä taas tää asia ja lopullisesti tallataan tää juttu, että et sä oot minkä värinä tahansa, niin sä oot ihan sama arvoinen. Mut tää pointti, miksi mä nyt tästä puhun, niin on se, että sit ääripäät ei ole kanskaan hyviä. Tai mikä mä oon sanoa, mutta mun mielipide on se, että ääripäät on aika huonoja. Nyt on sitten Eskimo-puikon logo vaihdetaan tai nimi vaihdetaan, ettei saa olla enää Eskimo, kun se on ollut aina se. Ja Uncle Ben's Riisistä otetaan se naama sieltä pois. Ja tällaisia juttuja, mitkä ei välttämättä kukaan edes tajunnut, että ne vois loukkaa ketään. Ja tämä huimpettuu silleen mun omassa elämässä, kun mä oon katsonut, että Liverpoolissa nyt spreijataan Penny Lanen kylttiä ja se Penny sieltä pois, koska joku viisas on keksinyt, että jos mennään tosi kauas historiassa, niin sieltä löytyy joku orjapiiskuri sieltä, minkä mukaan ilmeisesti tämä katu on aikanaan sanoi nimensä. Ja mutta kaikkihan me tiedetään se ihan niin kuin rakkauden lähteenä tämä paikka. Siellä ei mitään pahaa. Se on Beatlesin kotikatu, Penny Lane. Ja vielä kun tämä hanke ei ole mennyt niin pitkälle, että se Penny otettaisiin siitä pois, niin lavlataan vielä tämä sanolla Penny Lane tai viisi ja pannaan se, kirjoitetaan se biisilistaakin Penny Lane. Vielä kun se on laillista. Ei muuta.
Penny Lane, there is a barber showing photographs of every head he has a blessed to know. And all the people that come and go stop and say hello. On a corner in a banker with a motor car, the little children left a thing behind his back. Train.
though she feels as if she's in a play, she's anyway. In Penny Lane, the barber says another customer. You see the packers in here waiting for the trim. And then the fireman rushes in from the bar.
Kiitos.
Riippuu, mitä meillä on aikaa. Teillä on varmaan siellä kännyköitä. Paljon tämä setti vielä kestää. Onko? Soitetaan sitten kaikki nämä, mitä ollaan sovittu. Ei meilläkään mikään kiire, ainakaan mulla jo. Joo, makkaa lisää.
Joo, tuo on hyvä.
Se on bad to me.
Tällaisen helmen Nanto muiden laulettavaksi, ei itse edes pittineet tätä ikinä levyttä.
toi Wait.
Kesää odotellessa tässä. Tästä tulee aina kesä mieleen. Kiitti.
It's been a long time, now I'm coming back home. I've been away now, oh. If the heart breaks, don't wait, turn me away. And if the heart's wrong, hold on, I'm overlaid. Wait till I come back to your side. We forget the tears we cried. I feel the soul, you want to know. But I've been good as I can be. And if you do, trust in you, and know that you will wait from me. It's been a long time, now I'm coming back home. I've been away now, oh how I've been alone. Wait till I come back to your side. We forget the tears we cried. I feel the soul you want.
you know, but I'll be good as I can be. And if you do, I'm trusting you. And know that you will wait from me. And if your heart's wrong, hold on, I won't lay. And if your heart breaks, don't wait, tear me away. Wait till I come back to your side. When we'll get the tears we cry. It's been a long time, now I'm coming back on. I've been away now, oh how I've been alone.
Joo, okei. Hei, tuhannet kiitokset varsinkin järjestäjille, että kaverit halus tästä COVID-19 huolimatta niin järkkää edes jotain ohjelmaa ihmisille. Se on ihan mieletön teko. Ajatelkaa, ne ajattelee teitä ja meitä, noin kaksi jannua tuolla, missä ne nyt onkin. Ne tekee tätä ihan sydämestään tätä asiaa. Mä oon siihen tulokseen tullut heti oikeastaan ekan tapaamisen jälkeen. Ja toivottavasti tämä homma tästä laantuu ja päästään sinne Kultsalla ja kaikkea sellaista mukavaa. Ja täällä on mies, joka vaikuttaa siellä täällä stadissa. Ehkä Veikkolassa eniten, hän nukkuu useimmiten yönsä siellä. Ja Veikkolan filharmonikoksikin kutsuttu, mutta tänään tuli uutta tietoa. Nimittäin Juha Heikkilä on Tapiolan musiikkiopiston kasvattaja. Ja Tapiolan musiikki on tuossa vieressä. Eli kaikki nämä pikkutilut ja tällaiset toitotukset, nämä makeat jutut, mitä sä teet, niin no periaatteessa lähtöisin tuolta noin opinahjoista, kun sä oot siellä soittanut klassista. Eikö klassista se oli?
Kyllä, joo.
Joo. Näin, se oli. Näin ne asiat etenee. Ja tässä on tulos.
Once to the way to get back home world. Once to the way to get back home and sleep pretty darling, do not cry. And I will sing a lullaby. Sing a lullaby. Once to the way to get back home world. Once to the way to get back home. Sleep with it, darling, do not cry. Sing a lullaby. Thank you.
Lasse siellä soittelee, niin kuin tiedätte. Ja Jiri Bertola basso. Kiitos.
Kiitos. Thank you.
Okay.
Vielä yksi. Okay.
Joo, joo.
Tässä keikalla mä oon miettinyt monesti tämmöistä tasapainoilua ja vähän kuin joku tasohyppelypeli, että nyt tulee taas semmoinen kohta ja ei vitsi nyt, no oikein mä pääsin ja noin. Niin mä mietin, että mitä se polkelaa, kun silloin välillä se vetää 2 tuntia 45 ja huomaa, että sillä on ääni välillä vähän, että ei saakeli. Niin se vaan vetää. Ja niin mekin vedetään.
Todella.
Hey Jude.
Kyllä.
Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let it into your heart. Then you can start to make it better. Hey Jude. Don't be afraid, you were made to go all together. Then let it to enter into your heart. Then you can start to make it better.
Take a sad song and make it better. na na. Nice t-shirt. Na. Vielä kerran. Aika hyvä koronavolaks. Nimittäin tyhjää on. Ei tähän voi lopettaa. Yksi kerta vielä. Kiitos teille. Kiitos järkkärit ja kiitos Tinos myös.
Next year.
Thank you very much. Peace and love, Helsinki. Yeah, I was probably 6 or 7 years old, and the radio was always on in my house. I had four older sisters, you know, so there was always music on, and of course, television, Ed Sullivan, and I was impressed by Elvis Presley, and so I would mimic as a seven-year-old, you know, singing Nothing But a Hound Dog, playing air guitar, you know, and singing. And my dad saw me doing that. And we had a routine every 2 weeks. We went to the barbershop. I got a brush cut, you know, and he got a hairdo called the Princeton because it was just a little longer in front. But he'd have me get up and he goes, Mike, you know, sing Nothing But a Hound Dog. And I would do that in the barbershop. Guys that were waiting to get the haircut, you know, they'd clap, and it was, yeah, I guess that's really how it started. Yeah. I grew up in a family of five sisters, and my grandmother lived with us. So there were nine of us growing up, you know, and it was just me and my dad. We were the only guys. We were drowning in a sea of estrogen, if you know what I mean. Anyway, I saw the Beatles just like everyone else in America when they came to New York to be on the Ed Sullivan Show in 1964, okay? And that's when everyone wanted to play guitar and drums and be in a band after that. You know, they started, that was huge. After she's, it might have been before she saw the Beatles, because we heard them, you know, on the radio. And she says, she asked my mother one day if she could take me over to her girlfriend's house. They wanted me to play the drums. And they made cardboard guitars. I went to the house. We went up into an attic room. And there were the record player with the Beatles' new album, their first album on it. And the girls had cardboard guitars, and they had all the pots and pans from the kitchen set up on a card table. And I was always getting in trouble for pounding on stuff. And this was the first time in my life, my short life at 10, that I was going to be able to pound on stuff and not get in trouble. It was a big deal for me, okay? And I got to play, you know, Ringo on that day. And so that was the beginning of the drumming thing, you know. However, I did go on to I wanted to drum, guitar lessons. My parents got me guitar lessons. And through junior high, I played in a band. I played rhythm guitar, I played bass guitar. But it wasn't until 1979 that I decided I wanted to be a drummer, seriously. And it was due to Stuart Copeland, the drummer for the Police, the way he played drums. That's what pushed me over the edge to say, I want to be a drummer. I want to play like that. But always loving the Beatles and being in classic rock bands and Beatle bands over the years too as a drummer. Well, it wasn't a plan of mine. I didn't wake up one day and go, I want to be a Ringo Starr tribute artist. That never happened, you know. But I do believe that it's my whole life prepared me to do this and just do it naturally, you know. How it happened was I had a friend of mine, a bass player, who had a couple sons that were younger, and we were all Beatle fans, and we met at a Beatle festival in Chicago almost 30 years ago, okay? And I went to that Beatle fest, and I went, wow, this is so cool, you know? And I go, I'm never coming back to the Beatle Fest again without a band, because they had a battle of the bands every Sunday night, you know, at this Beatle Festival. So for all those years, I played drums with, we changed our names over the year, you know, like we were the Bent Back Tulips 1 year from, you know, Glass Onion. So this 1 year we handpicked winners from past Beatle festivals that everyone knew, and they became my all-star band. And we did Never Without You, the song that Mark Hudson and Ringo wrote for George after he passed away. And we won the event with that song, and the people loved the Ringer Star, you know. And I thought, well, I'm going to go home now like I do every year and, you know, cut my beard and let my hair grow. And I immediately got approached by a festival director from Arkansas, Beatles at the Ridge, it's called. And he came up to me as soon as I walked off stage and said, I need you in a few weeks down at my Beatle Festival, you know. And he says, you don't have to perform, just walk around and don't go out of character as Ringo Starr. So I did that, and it was pretty incredible, because these people in this sleepy little town, they all thought I was Ringo. And it got really intense, you know. I mean, it was the first time that I was followed and interviewed by the news, and, you know, he didn't want me to go out of character. People are having me sign their T-shirts and their arms and hands and pulling money out of their pocket. You know, I had to draw the line. They were bringing me Beatle albums to sign, you know, and, you know, I it was overwhelming, actually. But that promoter, Charles Snapp, great guy, he did say, you should think about being a tribute artist at some point. And I thought about that. And the following year, me and my friend Ed Primo decided to make a website and some business cards. And our first trip was down to Abbey Road on the river in Louisville, Kentucky. And I went down there and walked around, you know, took pictures with people. That everyone was pretty impressed with it. And then I walked around and asked bands, hey, do you mind if I sit in and play the drums or sing a song? And there were bands from all over the world down there, you know, and they were happy to let me come up and sing a song or two. And I found out that there was a brochure there for the International Beatle Festival. And also Charles Rosenay, who does tours to London and Liverpool for the International Fest, called the Magical History Tour. And I thought, well, I need to go to that, you know, go unannounced, you know. Well, that's, had I not gone to Louisville, I wouldn't have found out about the International Fest or Charles Rosenay. So I followed up on that and hired a videographer to go with me and document the trip. And it was a two-week trip, a week in London. You see all the sites, you know, where the Beatles live. We got to record in Abbey Road Studio 2, which was an incredible. The 70 of us on this trip got to sing All You Need Is Love and record it. And you can see that video on YouTube under Ringer Starr. But, then the second week we go to Liverpool for the International Festival. And I did the same thing there as I did in Louisville, and asked bands if I could sit in or sing a song and play drums. And they did. And the festival directors found out, they heard rumor that there's this guy from America who looks like Ringo. He's the same size. He sings and plays the drums. And they immediately asked me to perform at the Liverpool Philharmonic for a George Harrison tribute night. And so I got to sing Never Without You again, okay, that I won back in Chicago, you know, with that song. Well, little did I know that Mark Hudson was there. And I knew that Mark produced Ringo albums, but, and there he is in Liverpool. And he's with Joey Mullen from Badfinger. So I agreed to do the song. I was the last artist of the night. The Hare Krishna people were there. I believe Mike McCartney was there, Paul's brother. So everyone thought Mark was going to do the song, you know. And so Mark says, and ladies and gentlemen, Ringo Starr. Well, I don't think most people heard Ringo. They heard Ringo. And of course, I walk out in a black suit and a white shirt. And the people, you know, they don't know what to think, you know. And I did the song. I got a standing ovation. And that's when my life changed. Once I walked off that stage, I had no idea that the promoters and festival directors from all over the world come to this international fest looking for new talent to bring to their country or city, you know. And for the next five and a half, 6 years, I was traveling all over the world, 7 countries multiple times, you know. I mean, with great musicians. I ended up having, I think I have like 18 supporting all-star bands, you know, from Peru, 5 bands in Brazil, you know, Mexico City, Belgium, you know, McDonald's Farm from Scotland, a couple bands in 3 bands in Finland, you know. So it's been quite a journey, and in between, you know, radio and television and newsprint interviews. So I never thought this would turn into this. And then come to find out, I looked to see who would be my competition, you know, because there's so many John Lennon tribute artists, McCartney, Beatle band tribute artists. And I couldn't find another one on the planet, on the globe, of someone who's doing what I'm doing. So that just blew my mind that I'm the only one, you know. I feel like a chosen one, you know, and that I'm, you know, to be able to not only be a Beatle tribute artist, but to be Ringo and then be the only one is, I guess it was my destiny, without a doubt, you know. I mean, and here I am, and it's still going on, you know. I love it. So as you know, over the years with his all-star band, he's had great, great, popular, well-known rock and roll all-stars, you know. And his current band, which is, I think this is maybe their 6th year or so, you know, Ringo does a few songs when he comes out, then he goes up behind the drum kit and they go around the band, you know, like they start with, when Todd Rundgren was in the band and he would do his 2 hits, you know, a couple hits. They go to Steve Lukather, you know, and he'd do some of the Toto songs that everyone knows. And so they go around the band. And I've always wanted to do that, but never had that luxury, so to speak, because typically the bands that supported me, these Beatle bands, would come out and do their set first, you know, what they do. And then I would come out and they'd be my supporting band. They would do my material, the Ringo material. Well, now, you know, I have a band in Rochester, Minnesota, that is very close to Ringo's band. But when we did the concerts, that I wasn't prepared to go around the band yet. So I've been doing that this year for the first time here in Detroit. And it's gone over really well because we've handpicked some really good rockers from the 70s, you know, and I've gotten incredible. Everyone in the band is great in their own right. But I now have a keyboard player that just rips it up, and guitar players, both of them. So it's really the closest thing to a Ringo Starr show that you can see. Okay, and I plan on doing that with the Beat Brothers as well, you know. Well, I spent one night in Helsinki once. I didn't get to see anything. My flight was canceled back to the U.S. when I played in Lapua, with the Beat Brothers the last time. So I've never been to Helsinki, and I heard it's a rockin' city, you know, that anyone who is anyone, you know, whoever plays there or performs there, that's the city, you know. So I'm pretty excited about that. And of course, I'm sure there'll be people from Tampere that I know, friends there. You know, to get to see the Beat Brothers again, they're a great band, always love them. And the festivals are so great, and it'll just be wonderful to come see everybody again and meet you in person. Thank you too for all you do, seriously, you know, to have that kind of passion, you know, and to bring people together, you know, for peace and love and Beatles is just a beautiful thing. It doesn't get any better than that. I've been to many, many Beatle festivals all over the world, and it's an atmosphere, and the energy is how you would love the rest of the world to be all the time. You know, I don't want to leave these festivals because of the positive and love-filled energy there. And it's kind of a drag to come back to the real world, you know, with all the insaneness. Thank you very much. Peace and love, Helsinki.